Hello all respected participants, welcome to the online short-term course on research methodology which is organized by Sri RLT College of Science, Akola in collaboration with UCTA and MSI. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about a topic on how the candidate enter in PhD program via UGC, CSIR NET, GATE, JEST entrance exam. And also discuss about the CSIR JRF Fellowship and National Institute of Technology in India for the PhD program. So myself, Shailen Jaiswal, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, Sri RLT College of Science, Akola. So as we know about the eligible criteria for the admission in the PhD program, according to the ordinance of many universities, the candidate should qualify the PhD entrance test which is conducted by the universities in which candidate want to do his or her PhD. So this is the basic criteria for all universities. But the candidate who have qualified UGC, CSIR NET, GATE or MPhil, they are exempted from the PhD entrance test. The third part is that the teacher fellowship. In this scheme, if you are the teacher appointed in the college or universities on a regular basis and you have 3 year teacher experience but not your age is more than 50, then you can also exempt it from this paid examination. So among these 3 points, we are going to discuss about the point number 2. So how the candidate will enter in the PhD program via qualifying the CSIR, NET, JRF or GATE examination. So before going to discuss this point, we are focusing on the requirement of the entrance examination for the candidate. So all regular and full-time category candidate must satisfy one of the following requirement in addition to satisfying eligible requirement related to the qualifying degree. If the qualifying degree in BE, BTEC or BDS or equivalent, then candidate must have valid and qualifying GATE score above the prescribed cutoff level. If the qualifying degree is MSc or equivalent, then candidate must have valid and qualifying GATE score above the prescribed cutoff level or valid CSIR NET JRF qualification. If the qualifying degree is MA in Humanities and Social Science disciplines or equivalent, then candidate must have valid UGC NET JRF or UGC NET LS qualification. Or else, qualifying in any other national level examination for research fellowship for pursuing PhD, and it should be valid for another 3 to 6 months from the date of admission to the PhD program. So before going to discuss this point, we are focusing on the requirement of this entrance exam for the candidate. So first, we see what is about the CSIR NET, UGC NET. The Council of Scientific and Industry Research, CSIR, is a premier research organization which has been ranked among the world's largest publicly funded research and development bodies. So the CSIR conduct exam for the following 6 subjects. The subjects are Chemical Science, Mathematical Science, Physical Science, Life Science, Engineering Science, Earth and Atmosphere, Oceans and Planetary Science. So this is about the CSIR NET. Then next is UGC NET. The National Eligibility Test, also known as UGC NET or CBSE NET, is a test to determine eligibility for the college and university level lectureship and for the award of Junior Research Fellowship, short form is GRF. It aims to ensure minimum standard for the entrance in the teaching profession and research. So the National Testing Agency conducted a UGC NET examination for 82 different subjects, including the paper one. And the most of this subject belong to the non-science stream like arts, humanities, education, management, etc. So here we see the application procedure for the UGC CSIR NET. So the online application for the GRF NET are invited twice a year on all India in the month of June and in the month of December. So see here about the age limit of the candidate. The upper age limit for applying the award of GRF shall be 28 years, which is relaxed up to the 5 years in the case of candidate belonging to the SC, ST, OBC or physically handicapped, visually handicapped and the female applicant. So the UGC CSIR conduct National Eligibility Test exam every year. The exam involves two certifications. So the first certification is a NET LS. LS means is a long form of LS is lectureship. And is valid to the lifetime. So if the candidate qualifying NET LS, then it should be appear for the lectureship and the validity is lifetime. And the next is the NET GRF. If the candidate achieve the certificate of NET GRF, this is valid for the 2 years and it's not extendable. And the cutoff of the NET GRF are higher than the NET LS. And the next is the opportunity after qualifying the NET LS and the NET GRF. So the qualifying for the NET LS will make you eligible to apply for the teaching position in Indian colleges and universities and will make you eligible for the government funded projects. While qualifying GRF provide multiple benefits such as eligibility for the lectureship, eligibility PhD entrance exam and the full financial support to the PhD. So, if you want more information about the UGC NET, UGC CSIR NET, you can go through this link. So, next year we discuss about the GATE examination, which is also one of the entrance exam to entering the PhD program. So, what is the long form of the GATE? It's a graduate aptitude test in engineering. Is a national level exam. It is conducted to offer admission into master degree and direct doctorate program in engineering, technology, architecture and doctorate program in the relevant branches of the science. So the Indian Institute of Technology, IIT Madras will conduct GATE in online mode in the month of January or February every year for 24 papers or subject UGCIS. So GATE is a national level postgraduate entrance exam for admission to ME, MTech and PhD. So GATE is an examination conducted jointly by the Indian Institute of Science, ISSC Bangalore and the 7 Indian Institute of Technology. The name is IIT Mumbai, IIT Delhi, Guwahati, Kanpur, Kharagpur, Madras and Roorkee on behalf of National Coordination Board. So for more detail about the GATE examination, you will go through this link. The next is the CHESS exam. So the Joint Entrance Screening Test is a short form is the CHESS is conducted to the shortlist aspirant for admission in the PhD or integrated PhD program in the subject like physics, theoretical computer science, neuroscience or the computational biology. So for the more detail about this exam, you will also go to this link. Now here we see the short summary of these above slides. Opportunity after qualifying the CSIR NET, GRF and GATE. The CSIR NET qualification comes into two categories, GRF and lectureship. If the candidate are GRF qualified, they will get a monthly stipend from the CSIR or UGC if they join PhD in any institute in the India. Also qualified, candidate can apply for the PhD in many good institutions where minimum criteria to apply for the PhD is qualifying NET GATE.
Many institutes prefer to take student qualified GRF for PhD since funding is easy there. However, one cannot directly get into the PhD after qualifying NET. He or she have to satisfy minimum eligibility criteria and crack the PhD interview of the institute. As a CSIR NET qualified candidates will exempted from the PhD entrance exam, but they has to appear for interview, so it's not kind for direct entry, everything based on their performance in the interview. So the candidate who have qualified UGC NET including GRF, UGC CSIR NET including GRF, DBT GRF, ICMR GRF, TST Inspire, Ayush NET or equivalent national level examination fellowship as identified by the DRC GATE teacher fellowship holder can directly appear for the interview.
So next, here we will discuss about the scholarship or stipend which is provided by the CSIR and the IITs for the admitted candidate. So as per the latest updates, the central government has enhanced monthly stipend allotted to the GRF, SRF and PhD scholar in the field of science and technology. The GRF selected candidate through the CSIR UGC National Eligibility Test will receive the stipend of INR 31,000 per month for the period of 2 years. In addition, annual concurrent grant of INR 20,000 per fellow will be provided to the university or institute. So this is about the CSIR funding, and for about the IITs, the financial aid is available to the PhD program in the IITs. For PhD student, the corresponding financial assistance is rupees 80,000 for engineering and 60,000 for science and social science for the first 2 years, and thereafter it is raised to the 20,000 and 18,000 respectively for another 2 years. So after qualifying the CSIR UGC NET, GATE and GIST, it's a candidate choice where they approaches to join the PhD program. The candidate can approach the universities, CSIR laboratories and IITs. It's a depend upon this candidate choice. So now here we will discuss about the various institute in India for the PhD program. So first we will see about the universities. So the universities in India which award PhD degree are recognized by the University Grant Commission. It includes both private and public universities, which again it power from the Universities Grant Commissions Act 1956. The different types of university include there is the first is the Central University. So working under the Department of Higher Education in the Union Human Resource Development Ministry. The second is the state universities are controlled by the state government of each of the state and territories of India. Third is deemed universities that have a status of autonomy granted by the Department of Higher Education. And the fourth is the private universities are also approached by the UGC. However, they are not allowed to have off-campus affiliated college. So next about the IITs. So here we discuss about the IITs. If the candidate have a good score on the GATE or the CSIR exam, they can also approach to the IITs also. The first, let's see here about the IITs. The first Indian Institute of Technologies, short form is IITs, was set up in the 1951 in the Kharagpur, and today the total number of IITs stand at 23. So here we see the 23 list of 23 IITs, and the ranking given to the IITs by the MHRD NIRF on the basis of these five parameters shown in the slide. So you can watch see this the list of 23 IITs by pausing this video. So here the list of 23 IITs is depend upon the candidate choice to where to go to these IITs after qualifying or set great score in the GATE and the CSIR examinations. The student or the candidate can also go to the CSIR laboratory for this research or the PhD program. So here there is 43 CSIR laboratories. Here we show the list of the CSIR laboratories. So you can also watch or see this name of the CSIR laboratory by pausing this video. So total the 43 CSIR laboratories in the India in different topics and subjects. So this is all about the entrance exam, our CSIR UGC NET GATE, JEST. So thank you very much.